The goal in doing this house was to show how one can do a relatively affordable, urban, energy efficient house on a very tight site. And I think that cities all over the world actually have old houses on tight urban sites that need to be redeveloped. And I was hoping that this house would be an example of what you could do and what's possible in these situations.
Hey guys, we're at the future site of Tom Fisher and his wife Claudia's energy efficient home in beautiful St. Paul, Minnesota. Let's go hear more about it.
So I'm Tom Fisher. I live in St. Paul, Minnesota. I'm a professor in the School of Architecture and I teach urban design at the University of Minnesota here in the Twin Cities. And looking forward to living in a new energy efficient house. Well, the house was designed so that you could live on one floor, so it was designed to age in place in, and so it has everything you need on the main floor. The idea of the house was to make it as energy efficient as possible, so it will have a solar array on the south-facing roof slope. There's good solar access, and that was actually one reason we picked that site. We knew that, you know, it would be able to basically generate a lot of its energy off the sun. It has highly insulated walls and roof and floor and windows, all new windows, and so it'll be very energy efficient. It's not actually a passive house in terms of being certified as a passive house, but our architects feel that it's going to come very close to that standard anyway. So we're in the demolition phase. What we did is we purchased this small house right behind our existing house and had thought initially that we could renovate it, but there was just too much structural damage that had happened over the last 100 years in the house. And so it really was less expensive to just start over from the foundation up. So that's what we're going to do. They plan to recycle about 80% of the existing building materials. I mean, they are sorting it into, the house had a cement stucco exterior, so they're sorting the stucco into one dumpster. They've sorted metal, and then they've also sorted wood. They took all of the appliances out and are recycling that. And there were stained glass windows that got recycled, and so there was a lot of material in the house itself that has been handled so that it'll be recyclable in some form. And then we're keeping the existing foundation and then building up from that. That was also largely not only money-saving effort, but also to not disturb the existing mature trees on the site, because once you start digging a foundation, you really can damage all of the trees, some of which are themselves over 100 years old. So even though the footprint of the house is relatively small, the whole house is only 1,700 square feet, and the first floor is a little over 1,000 square feet, so it's not that big. And then by using the windows to project out, you feel as if there's more space, and as well you can have window seats, so you can avoid having as much furniture because you can sit in the windows. You know, the idea was to be able to live off the grid as much as possible in terms of energy. There is a gas line that was into the existing house that we're just going to cap, so there'll be no fossil fuels used in the house itself, which in one reason was just simply because we didn't want carbon monoxide in the house. We didn't want to have to ventilate that, and plus we also wanted to decarbonize the house so that we could basically be living off of solar power as much as possible. There'll be a Tesla power wall in the basement so that we'll be able to have battery power that can hold us over at night, so we don't have to draw from the grid, as well as in, you know, if power goes out. So we're trying to be as responsible as we can in terms of energy. I think that the good thing about the design process is it also forces you to sort of ask, well, what do we really need, as opposed to what do we think we need or think we want?